Hi everybody. So now we are going to discuss hotel management system project. So it contains both the things, rooms as well as restaurant items. Okay, we are going to see this project right now. So first of all, we need what are the things we need before starting this project. We are going to see that. So the software's requirement for this project is Python, okay, Python 3.7.4 version. Okay, I'm going to show that. I'm opening that project. So from here we need to download Windows 86 web-based installer. We need to download this thing. Okay, so we need to click on this and download. So this is for Python interpreter, and click on this web-based installer. Okay, for PyCharm is the IDLE we are going to use in this projects. So for PyCharm we will be installing this thing. I will be showing that. Okay, click on community, download this community, click on community. Okay, so these are the two different softwares we need to run this project. So these are the two different things. Okay, here we need to, I forgot to write down the community version. Community, I need to click. Okay, so these are the softwares we need to run this project. I'm going to open the project right now. Okay, right click on this project, open with the PyCharm community edition. We can see this. So before going to run this project, we need to double click on requirements.txt. We need to select the interpreter, file, settings, click on settings, will be open like this. Click on HMS major, click on project interpreter, open this and click on Python 3.7 version, virtual environment. Okay, so if it does not find, just click on show all, it will show. Otherwise, if it is, even though it is not able to show, just click on plus, it will be shown. Will be shown like this. What are the interpreters present in our system? It will be shown like this. Click on OK. Okay, now it is already existing, so we no need to do that. Okay, it is selected. So click on Python interpreter, it will be open like this. You can see all the packages directly. We can click on OK. So these are the packages we need to be installed in our project before running the project. Okay, so for that reason we'll be just typing this command at the prompt, just typing the command pip install requirements dot txt. This command we need to type. I'm copying this text and pasting here. Click on enter. So the whole thing, these packages, enter packages, it will be downloaded in our system. Enter packages will be downloaded in our system. Now we can use our project. So we need to check our directory, so that it must present manage.py. We must see the manage.py dir. Click on directory. So here we can see the manage.py. So from these folders we need to go to the path from the desktop, HMS major, HMS folder, CD HMS. Okay, so here we can find the manage.py. So we can You can see here manage.py, isn't it? So click on Python manage.py. Manage.py run server. Okay. If you type this command, it will be opened. The project will be opened like this. Okay, we'll be getting project like this, where after finishing all these downloads, okay, I have previously done this downloads requirements.txt this command, okay, this command you can see here. So with this command, I have downloaded all the pip install. We can see here, pip install minus r. So I have written this command here, pip install minus r requirements. First of all, we need to download this. Okay, first thing is we need to download the Python software. This is the version it will be working. We need to download this software from here. Just copy and paste it in the browser, and you need to download this Windows x86 web-based installer. After that, PyCharm community, you need to download PyCharm community, you need to download this. Okay, after that, open this project. You need to open this project. You need to open this project by right click on this open folder as a PyCharm community edition. So it was already open, no? So it will be coming like this, and you need to type this command. The next thing is pip install, make sure you are in the directory so that you can see the manage.py, you can see here, isn't it? So first of all, go to the path where it is, manage.py is there, hms underscore major, and hms, you can see here cd hms. In that cd hms you can see the manage.py, isn't it? So there you need to type this command. Before that, you need to type this command, pip install manage.py at the place requirements.txt, and this all packages it will be installed in our project. Okay, I'm going to open this project. When we click on this command, which command? Python manage.py run server. If you just click on this server command, it will be opened like this. I will be showing you. I'll be copying and pasting this command here. So this is the next command we need to type. Okay, then we'll be getting localhost number. Click on this link. This local host. Okay, so these are the things we need to do. Now the code will be opened, the project will be opened. I will be showing that project. Just to see, just click on this, it will be opened. So the project will be opened like this. Okay, so this is the entire hotel management system. It contains rooms allocation, okay, booking the rooms, and guest. We can see the guest present in our hotel, and rooms, we can see the number of rooms available, and booking of the rooms. This is the home page. Here we can see all the details. What are the details? We can see available rooms, occupied rooms, available for single bedroom, available for double bedrooms, number of double bedrooms, number of single bedrooms, number of rooms available of child bedroom. These are all the things we can see here. We can search here also. If we need anything, we can search like this. The dates will be today's date. That will be from today to 1 week. It will be 1 week. Okay, it will be running for 1 week. We can see the all the details here. If we click on search, we can see all the details. So 104 room is available, and it contains single bed, double bed, and child bed. If I don't want, I mean, if I need only single bed, I can search like this. Single bed, I can search that. I can see two rooms, 302 and 104. This is the floor number. 3 is the floor number. 302 is the third floor, second room, and 104 is the first floor, fourth room. That is the thing. So here home page, we can see all the things. Home page, we can see all the available rooms in our hotel. We can see here all the available rooms in the hotel. We can see here. Okay, 1 minute. And also all the information also we can see here, all the available rooms, everything information from the database it will be fetching and it will be showing here. Okay, number of rooms available, child beds available, rooms in our hotel, it will be seen here. So this is hotel management system, and it contains booking of the rooms, guest, and also restaurant supplied food item supplied to this particular guest. Okay, so now we are going to see what are the things we are going to see. So first, going to the guest, we need to add minimum 10 guests like this. Add new guest, we can add guest from here. Okay, I'm showing one example how to add the guest. So image is an optional, it's not compulsory. ID, we can provide it as Aadhaar card number or PAN card number, we can provide any of that. And email ID, we can provide anything. Just it's a sample, just I am adding a sample. So we need to add guest like this, add a guest. So it will be added like this. We can see the guest, 4 guests are available. You can add the guest like this. We need to add at least 10 guests for this, and the rooms also we need to add. Rooms, we can see the rooms. Okay, so add room. This number contains first digit, contains the floor. Floor 104 means first floor, fourth room. The room number is 104. 3 means third floor, first room, third floor. Like this we need to add the rooms. Okay, so we will be adding like this 202, and the price of the room is $100. We can put anything, whatever we want, we can put the price of the room, and we can change all the things, whatever we want we can change. And this is the second floor, isn't it? 202. This is the second floor, and we can choose the image. If you want, you can download from the net, and we can choose the image, and we can just click on whatever the necessary things. I mean, if you want to put all the things in the room, we can just click on this. It will be automatically selected in the rooms. Save room, it will be selected in the room. Okay, so the room is added, 302 is added. You can see here, single bed is available, double bed is available, child bed is available, square meters we can see here. If you want, in the future we can edit, we can delete the rooms, we can edit the rooms like this. How many floors you want, how many rooms you want, you can just add here. You need to add here. And guest also, how many guests you want, you can add here. Add new guest, you can add from here the guest rooms. Okay, the guest also you need to add here. Now I am going to show you the booking of the rooms for the guest. I am going to show you the booking of the rooms for the guest. So booking, here we can see here booking. So rooms available, we can see here. Okay, we can click on any of the room, whatever you want. Bookings are not available, and information we can see here about the room, and updates we can see here. So we need to book the room. Booking rooms means, so it was the room available, checked in, it was the room available. Okay, we need to just click on that room. Okay, so with this room booking information, the client, the guest will be selecting the room. Okay, the guest will be selecting the room, We need to select the guest also. Guest, whatever, whoever the guest will be selecting the room. First, we need to select the room. Okay, he will be asking for the child bed, single bed or double bed, whatever he need. He will be asking non-smoking, smoking, he will be asking that. And we will be selecting the guest and we will be clicking on the add to this booking. Add to this booking. So the guest is successfully added to the booking. So finish booking. Finish booking means the room was booked with his name. This room was booked with his name. We can see the ID also, ID numbers also we can provide here. Okay, and whenever he will be checking out, okay, if I click on this room 301, it is already booked with the with this name, with this guy. Okay, so whenever he want to check out his room, just click on check out. And if you want to give any discount for him, you can give like this 5% or something like that. If he is a regular customer, we can give the discount. Okay, create invoice. You can see the 301 room, number of people is 5 people and 500 is the charge, sum is 500. We are creating a invoice. This is the bill automatically generated. It will be downloaded like this, and if you click on save, it will be saved, it will be downloaded. And if you double click on this, it can be seen that like this, the bill will be shown like this, it will be shown like this. We have given a 5% discount. This is the bill, hotel generated bill. You can pay by the QR code also. QR code also we can, this is the invoice number, this is the QR code. You can pay by QR code if you want, okay? So this will be the bill generation. So coming to the food supply. So room services we can use here. Room, if you click on room services, you can add here whatever the restaurant items we need. Okay, this is graphical user restaurant. Whatever restaurant item we used, just click on the item, and whatever we need to just add here. We need to add all the items here before doing that. Before doing that, we need to add all the items. For example, I am showing with an example, the price is the price I am putting the price as $15. Okay. I can take the image from the net. I can download it and I can take the image from the net. I can put here save item. Okay, the item will be saved. Compulsory we need to put the some item, some picture, isn't it? So I'll be putting some random picture, whatever may be the picture. Just for example, I will be putting some example. Okay, so I will be selecting some example. Save item. Save item. The items we can see here. This is the sambar, idli and mutton curry. We can see all those things. So this is the room service. This is the room service. Okay. So we will be adding to the guest. The room service, we will be adding the restaurant to that particular room service. Okay. We will be adding all the items which are needed for that guest. Update. And we can update all the things. We will be adding all the food items to that particular room service. Through room services will be booking also done, the food items also, booking also done with that room service. And along with that, we will be getting all the, we will be getting all the bill generated when we click on checkout. The food items whatever he had taken from that for the persons, it will be generated. Okay, so like this the bill will be generated. We can download that bill and we can show it, we can pay the bill. This is hotel management, complete hotel management system with room services along with the food along with the room services. Okay, so this is the thing. If you close this, it will be gone. This is the hotel, complete hotel management system. The project is explained with this. Okay, so you can go through this, all the things you need to, before using all these things, you need to add the rooms, guest and room services also we need to add. We need to add all the items. What are the room services? Not only food items, we can add all the things. We can add laundry. Okay, we can add so many things. We can add whatever the room services need, we can add all the things. And that will be added to the items. The customer's room service will be directly sending to these items. They will be selecting the items and that will be available to them. Okay, so this is about the project. Thank you so much.